numerous fights, multiple fires. Parents and neighbors demand change at a troubled Kansas City school. KMBC 9's Marcus Moore is live at Southwest Early College campus on Warnell. Marcus?
Laura, concerned residents say there needs to be a different approach here at the school, and the proof is in what has been happening this school year. The fire department has been called here some 50 times just this school year. And then on Friday, the situation boiled over when unruly kids set even more fires.
We are losing our kids, and so it's a great concern to me.
Community activist Ron Hunt is just the latest to speak out about the violence that erupted at the Southwest Early College campus on Friday. Three separate fires were intentionally set inside the building. Several fights broke out. It forced officials to dismiss school early.
It sounds like it's a correctional facility. And kids are just out of control.
Hunt says he saw this coming when the district decided to combine schools last year, and now they are dealing with the after effects. The school is already on its third principal just this year.
All Covington staff are people with PhDs, you know, they walk around, and these kids throw things at them, they spit on them.
Hunt believes it signals a need for a new approach, one similar to his Meet in the Middle program, where they worked with students at metro area schools. He says it was successful at Central High School, and it can be here too.
What I would do is work my program. If given us a chance, we'll come in for the first 30 days, pro bono.
Meanwhile, people who live nearby are reacting to the chaos that has gripped the school this year.
I'm mainly concerned for the kids that want to get a good education.
Jack Dunbar's kids graduated from the same school in the 80s. And now he hopes administrators can get things under control here and create a positive place for kids to learn, a feeling shared by Hunt.
I'm not here to criticize. I'm here to help out and do whatever I can do to help our children succeed.
And everyone we spoke with today said the same thing, that this was all about the kids. And by the way, despite all of these fires, no one has been injured. But according to the president of the teachers union, she says that one teacher was trampled when students were evacuating during that second fire on Friday.